haven't seen a video for this head unit line. I got a friend asking about it a lot, so I figured I'd take a sec to make a quick video. I just got it a couple days ago. I've only used it driving to work once yet, so don't know everything about it, but it's pretty straightforward. It's a JVC KD-AHD75BT. It's their Arsenal series. I bought this head unit because it had Bluetooth. I was primarily interested in the Bluetooth aspect of it, but turns out it's got a lot of other cool features that I didn't even realize I bought, which is always a plus, I guess. The one other good thing I liked about it was that you could program the display to be different colors, because a lot of these units, like I'm used to Alpine units, they usually have like blue, green, or amber. Sometimes not even amber. I put a Alpine XBA or XDA or whatever 305S in another car, and you have blue or red as a display mode, but the problem is the red is like almost purpley pink, so doesn't quite match the interior of this car here, which is a 95 BMW 525. So anyway, it was pretty straightforward procedure. It took like maybe 20 minutes to solder up the harness connector. I ordered everything from Crutchfield. They include the, I forget who makes it, Schroth or something like that, or whatever, but it's a simple connector that hooks up to the factory side of the car and then has bare leads, and then you tie that into the JVC included harness. For the most part, it was painless because, you know, yellow went to yellow, red went to red, black went to black, and then they had the speaker outputs, which were like, you know, green with a black stripe, and actually they all lined up too, from the aftermarket harness to the JVC harness. So that was nice. I mean, really, it took me 10 minutes to heat shrink and solder, probably, or 20 minutes to heat shrink and solder, probably do 10 minutes now, knowing that the wires went color to color. But anyway, they also include a wire there for you to hook up to the dimmer from the light switch control. That's kind of nice. But there's also a steering wheel input as well. But that's all boring stuff. You don't really care. It's also vehicle dependent. So if you're going to wire up some other car, don't listen to anything about that. Just look out your pinout, or usually the included harness has a diagram of what your car should have, and it's painless. But anyway, this head unit, I just actually put a new battery in the car. So this is almost as if the head unit were being turned on for the first time. And comes up JVC, FM, all that stuff. And then it does this little demo mode where it scrolls all the colors, which is stupid for, you know, my purposes. But it is nice because it lets you see all the colors you can do. The cool part about it is you can actually go in and program the colors RGB based. It's not like what most people might be typically familiar with a 0 to 255 value. It's like a 0 to 31 value. But still, you can dial in like full red, a little bit of blue, and some green. So basically, you can go in here and hit menu, and it'll go into this demo, and we're going to turn the demo off. And we're just going to go right away into the audio menu, because if I turn the volume up, this thing's going to beep every time I click, and it's annoying. So once you got that, it's pretty straightforward. You should probably switch hands to do this. I don't know if I can reach. So you can go in here and set the clock and all that stuff. Real easy to do. You got a 249. If you roll it around, it goes to PM. It's awkward because I'm reaching through my steering wheel right now. 250 now. So that was easy. You can go back in menu and set the color up. In. I happen to know this car. My display is really screwed up now. I happen to know this color. This car runs about this color 15 thing. We do all zones 15. So it's a little hard because of the glare, but I think you get the idea there. When it's in this menu, it goes into this white. You can go into color setup. You got a day color and a night color, separate stuff. Pretty cool. Then you got a menu color, also pretty cool. What else does it do? It has Bluetooth, which is kind of cool. I think technically my phone should still be paired up. The only thing that's not working is obviously the FM is sounding absolutely terrible. Another cool thing about it is it has, this model has the built-in HD tuner, which I didn't really think was worth anything, but it turns out, I guess I'm just not familiar with radio stuff. The HD is pretty cool because it has, it's over-the-air HD. So there's a cheaper model than this. It's like 129 or 139 or something like that. It doesn't include HD. I think it has all the other features other than the HD player. And the only difference is you won't get the free HD radio, which is kind of beat because I originally thought it was like Sirius or whatever, in which case I wasn't too thrilled, but I was like, yeah, I'll get it now. Maybe I'll get that someday. But I'm actually pretty happy I got this model because the free HD sounds a lot better when you're listening to it. Like, you don't get static. When there's silence, there's no static. A song, if it has silence in it, is just silent. Sounds really good. So that's pretty much it. I mean, you go in the menu, you hold the menu button to get into that menu that was in earlier, and then you go through menu, clock, color setup, dimmer, display. You can set like how it scrolls. Auto. So if a song or something comes up, as long as it scrolls through, it gives you that option. You can scroll it once, you can not scroll at all. That's that tagging thing for iPod stuff. I don't have an iPod, so I don't really care. EQ is pretty handy. They give you a couple different modes. Preset, which has like everything from, you know, all this typical crap. Easy EQ, which I like. You can just go through here, set your bass up or down, set your mid up or down, set your treble up or down. I usually run 6. That's easy. Done. Then there's Pro EQ. You can set the frequencies and stuff. Maybe once I hook my sub up, I'll get into that, because I know my sub doesn't like to run a certain frequency, so that's handy. But for right now, it's fine. So I just run the easy EQ. Audio gives you the fader, the balance. That's like front, back, left, right. Loud. That's kind of a pain, because if you turn loud on, it really bumps the levels up, which sounds good, except for the fact that my radio is on like level 2, and I think that has to do with the fact that I'm feeding a factory amp. I think you can get a PAC device basically to convert the speaker level outputs on the back of the head unit to a line level output, but I never mess with that. I don't really care. I just don't use loud. I mean, that's fine. I'm cool with that. This is a fixed volume because it's an FM radio, but you can set your Bluetooth to be like a fixed volume when you switch to it. That's kind of cool. Subwoofer on and off. Actually, I should turn it off. My RCAs are just kind of chilling back there. That beep again, amp gain, so on and so forth. The tuner, you can set up a different couple things. You can get areas and stuff. Like, if you're in Europe or whatever, you can change that. I haven't messed with anything in there. Clear all the tags. Bluetooth's handy. You know, you can get the phone. It says disconnect because my phone is connected. So even though I pulled the battery, and I actually pulled the head unit, and I'll explain why in a sec. It has a battery inside to keep your settings, so it knows my Bluetooth is paired and such, and that's pretty cool because I do tend to mess with cars a lot, so I'm always pulling the battery or pulling the radio out to run a wire, or, you know, who knows, but it keeps your settings other than your presets for your radio, which is kind of peculiar. I don't know if I don't have something set up or not, but so if you go in the phone, oh yeah, so you have your phone Bluetooth, you have your audio Bluetooth, because you can disconnect the audio from working. So if you just wanted to, for some reason, have your phone connected but not the sound through the radio, you could disconnect that aspect. I like that though. You can delete the pair, which is basically forget everything. You can do the phone book. You can send a phone book from the head unit to the phone. You can pull the phone book from the phone to the head unit. It's handy. I like that. You can set a pin. Can auto connect, you can do all that shit. So that's how that works. That's pretty much all the settings. There's some source, like, oh yeah, I turn off these externals because I don't use them. So I turn that one in, I turn that one off, and all this is going to do, I do use Bluetooth and I don't care about AM, but I don't think you can. Yeah, you can turn it off. Cool. So I just got basically FM and Bluetooth. What that means is when I go to the main menu here, if I hit source, I only get FM or Bluetooth, which is cool because that's all I use. And then the CD I'll switch when you pop one in. This thing has a CD player. I didn't realize it had a CD player, but I don't use CDs, but that's cool too. Outside of source select, I don't think there was anything else.
software version. Yeah, so we're selecting the software version. Then the demo, which we've turned off. So that's that. What's cool, though, is when you hit this phone button up here, it says that it's hooked up to a Droid X. It can pull up all my dialed numbers, which is really handy. And it's getting all that stuff from the phone, real time. I think it pulls the last 5 or 6 numbers. You can do the dialed numbers. You can get the last received numbers. You can get the last missed calls. But this one's cool, too. This is what I use most, is the phone book feature. You click this one, I can pull up anybody who's in my phone. And I haven't done anything other than just Bluetooth pair these devices. So there's nothing special going on here other than they're paired. And it's hot because if I were to click an entry here, it just dials. I mean, I know that's not that cool because most people have had that for a while, but I just got a Bluetooth head unit going from the factory tape deck in this thing, so pretty hyped about that. You can also dial a number if it's not in your phone book. Kind of a headache though, because you have to do one of these where you up and down. So I'd be like, you know, I live in 215. So if you did that, then you gotta go over one. You know, that's a pain in the ass to me. But whatever, it works. And you can do voice command. My phone doesn't support that though. You can dial by voice. Settings in here is you can pick the phone book. I'm using the in-phone phone book. You could use the phone book in the head unit, but I prefer the phone book in the phone. Auto answer, I turn that off because I don't want to answer phone calls automatically. People from work call a lot. Ringtones and stuff, you can change that. They ring through the speakers. When it rings, you can change it to a different color. So my normal stuff's going to be amber, and then I can set it to like white or something. You know, I'll set it there. So it gets your attention if you have the volume off. And this is just noise cancellation stuff. I leave that on mic level. You can turn that up or down. And message notice, I turn that off. That tells you if you have a text message. It doesn't read the text message to you. It just tells you you have one. And that's pretty much it. Pretty cool though, for $199. And of course it has one other feature I liked about it was it has 4.8 volt pre-outs, and it's got front, rear, and sub outputs, so that's nice. And it has an aux in here on the front, it has a USB in on the front, has a USB in the back, which is where they actually use one of those really small Bluetooth adapters, those USB Bluetooth adapters. That comes pre-installed like in the cable, it's basically a cable on the back. Like a 5-foot cable, USB cable, and in the end of it is your Bluetooth adapter. So I've got that bundled up right behind the dash. You know, I don't really want to run that to the glove box. I don't see myself putting an iPod in here, and if I do, like my fiance has an iPod, or an iPhone, she can just plug it in there. And this supplies, I think, 1 amp or 1.1 amps, which is great for charging. You can charge pretty much anything in there. I think you can even charge an iPad, although it'll charge slow, but it'll at least charge. So that's cool. So I had mentioned that I had the dash apart. Actually, I just put it back together a moment ago. It didn't take any time at all. I'm pretty familiar with this car. But the reason I had it apart was I'm going to probably be getting a new phone in a little bit, probably next month. But I really hate when there's that cable draped from your dock or your charger or whatever you got up on the dashboard. Strewn down all the way down there. It's like flopping around. Actually, the way this thing works is it can get stuck underneath this, and then the phone doesn't sit right, and I'm fumbling with it down the highway, and it's a pain in my ass. So I didn't like that. So what I did was I went on Amazon.com, and I ordered a simple, this is a Motorola Droid X. It's a little older now, but it works pretty well. I went and ordered a USB cable. I had one. I thought I was going to need a longer one, but I ended up not needing a really long one. Here's a shot from the back. It's a micro USB. I got it coming through the vent here. The whole vent pops out, so that's really convenient. But what I did was I went and behind the dashboard, I bought one of those USB 12 volt cigarette lighter adapter jobbies. And I basically I took it apart. It's the kind that sits in the plug with no, you know, there's actually USBs on the thing itself. It's probably an inch, maybe a half, or an inch, maybe 3/4 inches long. And I went and cut the end off, and I put
I put it behind the dash. I heat shrank the old thing and put it behind the dash. So it's basically hooked up all the time. And what it does, so let me not have a, it's basically hardwired power charger, I guess you could say. But it lets me, you know, get rid of having a cable coming down the front. I don't know if you'll be able to see this or not. Yeah, you can't really see, but in the top right corner there, it says, that the phone is charging. And what's cool is I can pull the key out, and it stays on. I got it wired to a constant 12 volt with a fuse, so that's nice. And that the thing I got is a Griffin power or something or other. But anyway, it supplies an amp also, supposedly, out of the 12 volt or the 5 volt for the USB. So that'll let you charge again a cell phone or two or whatever. And it's nice because you don't have to, you have no cables laying around. My phone's tethered to the head unit via Bluetooth, and it's plugged in via the hardwire, which just sits right there. Can't see that probably, but it's really nice. It's clean and out of the way. So anyway, that's a quick rundown on the JVC KD-AHD75BT. Overall, I'm pretty happy with it. Sounds great. Much better than what my my factory radio sounded like. It's got Bluetooth, it has the HD over-the-air radio, it can hook up a Sirius box if you want, and it's got the 4.8 volt preamp outputs, and has a pretty much infinite color display, so pretty cool.